Hello everybody, my name is Zohi Chaudhary, so let's get started with health effects of ionizing radiation now. Biological effects of ionizing radiation can be divided into two main categories, one that produces genetic effect, the other that produces somatic effect. Genetic effect essentially is effect that will be seen to the next generation, and it will be expressed through chromosome mutation, whereas somatic effect is shown to the individual itself. And this can have immediate effect, which is acute, and delayed effect, which is long-term or chronic. The immediate effect is manifested through radiation sickness, as well as other types of acute radiation syndrome, whereas the delayed effect is displayed through cancer such as leukemia and other types of cancer in the body, as well as fetal development abnormalities and shortening of life. So health effects of ionizing radiation can be generalized, and the biological effect are typically due to the ionization process that destroys the capacity for cell reproduction or division or cause cell mutation. A given total dose will cause more damage if received in a shorter period of time as compared to slowly. The somatic effects that are acute as compared to delayed, the acute one are relatively immediate effects and they're exposed, and the severity depends on the dosage, and that death usually results from damage to bone marrow or intestinal wall. The somatic effects that are delayed, the delayed effects to exposed person includes cancer, leukemia, cataract, life shortening from organ failure, and as well as abortion. The probability of an effect is proportional to the dose, and there's no threshold, unfortunately, for radiation exposure. Genetic effects are almost always irreversible, and offsprings will be the one that will face. This table shows the effective dosage in REM and the associated health effects and the time to onset. These are all acute health effects. So at low effective dosage, the health effects, it's relatively minimum, such as changes in blood chemistry, nausea, fatigue, and vomiting. And as the effective dosage increases to 1,000 or 2,000 REM, we can see that it can quickly lead to death within a short period of time or death in a very short period of time, depending on the specific exposure. The radiation tends to favor some organs more than the other. So some organs are more susceptible to radiation damage. These organs are typically the bone marrow, the gastrointestinal organs, gonads, or other fast-growing cells in the body. The central nervous system typically is relatively resistant to radiation damage. And one example in here, it shows that isotopes of iodine concentration in the thyroid gland, it concentrates in the thyroid gland, and this organ are considered critical for the specific nucleotide in here. This graph shows sensitivity to radiation. In red, you can see organs that are highly sensitive as compared to the organs that are less sensitive in black. So lung, breast, stomach, and colon are highly sensitive. On the other hand, kidneys or spleen or the skin is less sensitive to the radiation. So let's do a quick concept check. Acute exposures are A, amounts of radiation received over a short period of time. So it's a definition check. Which of the following is an early sign of radiation sickness? Vomiting B is among the one listed in here, the one that is earliest, as you can remember from that acute exposure to radiation. All right, thank you.